accessed our web app, you will see that it's divided into subjects. Subjects are divided into semesters. Semesters are divided into chapters, and chapters into lessons. So what we do is, I'll just initially, what I'm doing now is taking you through how we sort of, our content is created and is available on the app. So each of the chapters are broken down into different learning objectives. And most often, one or two learning objectives form a lesson. So in that sense, every chapter will have a maximum of 8 or 10, sometimes in case of mathematics and science. But in social science, we've sort of limited it to about 6 lessons. So all these 6 lessons will comprise a chapter, and each lesson mostly covers 1 or 2 learning objectives. So if you open this introduction to history, what we have here, and this is the way we've sort of designed all our lessons, you will find a red line on the screen that you're currently seeing. These are for teachers. So in case, and since all of you are going to be teaching, you will have to pay attention to these tabs or these slides the most, because they sort of give you an idea of what is coming next in the lesson. If you have any doubts, you can feel free to stop me anytime and clarify those doubts. So in this is called a lesson overview. We basically, the objective of this slide is to tell you what you're going to be teaching, or what the students are going to understand, why it is important for them to know this, and how we are going to do this. So for example, in this lesson, and because this is the first time, up to grade 5 students are not introduced to, they only have EVS. They have environmental science, and only from grade 6 do they branch out into history, political science, or civics as they call it sometimes, and geography. So this is the first time students are being introduced to these subjects. So what we start here with is how we understand history, or how we know about history. So this is what this lesson is about. It is about the sources of information and how they are used to record history. Actually, also one of the reasons I sort of chose this lesson was because I think in this time it is really important to, with so much information available to children, it is important that we inculcate this habit of asking, you know, developing the skill of them asking questions like, you know, how do you know this? Where did you get this information? And just generally, social science or history is viewed as remembering dates, you know, who won which battle, and these things. So what we have tried in these lessons is to move away from that and really understand and sort of understand the historical facts, and from where we are getting this information, and whether it is reliable, from whose perspective has it been told. We want to build these skills in children, that they understand that, you know, there are two faces always to, you know, a story, and maybe this story is told from one perspective, so there could be another perspective. I think these are the sort of broad guidelines through which we sort of develop our history lessons. Is there anything that you would like me to, if you have any doubts?
Yeah, is it good enough for us to prepare, or do we need to refer something else to prepare before we take the session?
No, I think if you go through the Mekshala lesson, it should suffice. But maybe for your understanding, or if there are many resources that are available online. So if you think, you know, that this could be done, and this is one of the way of doing it, so if you think this is the better way of doing something, an activity perhaps, I think you can sort of look through the web and get different ideas for.
Where do you go for looking for the resource if you need any? We will follow your leads.
So mostly, you know, mostly we try and sort of see 2-3. There is not a particular website that we go to.
We try to
we've gone to Wikipedia and if we've got some information,
okay.
Try and go to two other sites to see if, you know, the information that we have is correct, if there have been any sort of biases or anything like that.
Mm-hmm.
So it's good to go to 2-3 websites and get this information, because for science and math it's fairly easy.
Yeah.
Because they're all facts, you'll have multiple activities and all, and you know, such. But for social science, I think it's the idea is to sort of keep bringing the topic back to their lives, like how can we make it relevant for them.
Okay.
And I think that is one thing that as teachers, as social science teachers, we need to sort of keep going back to. Like, you know, draw parallels to maybe what is happening around them or, you know, their immediate community, to so that they can learn from that. And it sort of sticks with them longer if we do something like that.
Got it. Yeah, actually, the trigger for me to ask this question is one of the social teachers who joined from Madurai just 2 weeks back, she asked me the same question in our Saturday's sessions.
Yeah.
There she asked a specific topic. I asked, the students are getting bored in the social class, history class.
Mm.
Then I asked what topic. She said tribal upbringing. Okay. Then I was curious. I just did Google. I was able to get a lot of videos.
Yeah, yeah.
Including Khan Academy. So, there were good resources, especially with these tribals, etc. Tribals is an easy thing to find. Even today, there are tribals existing in the world.
Correct, correct.
Okay, so in that way. So, yesterday you were mentioning Choco Light. Can you briefly tell?
No, chocolate.
Chocolate.
Chocolate. But that is mostly, you know, for teachers. I mean, it is a great resource, but they're all for professional development. I mean, if maybe you'll find teachers who have taught the same topic in a different way. So this is to sort of, you know, it's like a peer learning and sharing sort of app.
How do you spell Choco?
Chalklit.
Okay. Go ahead.
Yeah.
I'll
just sort of briefly take you through this lesson.
Sure.
And if there are any doubts and if there's anything that you want to ask, you can stop me.
Sure, go ahead.
So like I said, the slides with the red line, these are the slides that you sort of need to prepare. And I think if you have fair knowledge of, you know, grade 6 history, you can even briefly go through the textbook, though that textbook and the way we form our lessons might be different. So it will probably help you to just understand what the textbook covers. Here what we've done is time distribution, and this is mainly designed for a 40-minute class. So this will help the teacher, you know, to sort of break down her time so that she doesn't spend too much time on a particular topic. We all know that sort of tends to happen in a classroom. So here we begin with a story, and this one example I think Kiran had also put up on the group. And so the story basically here, like we said, if you go back to the why we have done this, why it's important is they help introduce the concept more naturally, and also it shows what the relevance of the question that we're asking. How do we know what we know? So this is basically a story about a kid who asks his grandfather. When a grandfather starts telling a story, he questions the grandfather as to how he knows this. And if you go through the end of the story, you'll realize that even the grandfather doesn't think about this too much. So he he doesn't have an answer for this. There is another story that the grandpa tells about the Britishers, and the kid again asks, how did you know that the sailors were coming? Did anybody see the Britishers coming? This happened so much before, you know, their time. So how do you know that this happened? And that brings us to the question, how do we know anything from the past? So this is the sort of discussion that you want the children to be having. And I know this is online. So Kiran, I just wanted to know, do kids have access to the WhatsApp and or anything?
Yes, yes. We have, in fact, for the the trigger for today's session is we have to engage 20 students at least minimum, to, for whom we have given smartphones just a week back. And yesterday we did a dry run with them by bringing them online on Microsoft Teams. All of them came within 10 minutes. We were so very surprised.
Okay. And this will be what, an hour? An hour?
Yeah.
You're engaging them for an hour?
Yeah.
So, Kiran, this was the other thing that I wanted to check. Is it possible to sort of have a synchronous and asynchronous activity?
No, for us, we are in the exploratory journey. This is our day one. You have to tell us, we would like to experiment. We want to do both.
So, we did a training with a bunch of teachers, government school teachers from Goa.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the approach that they followed. So, they did about, 20 minutes of synchronous where the students come online.
Hmm.
And you are teaching them directly, like and this was on Google Meet, so everyone sees everyone, and the teacher is talking about a particular concept. And then what happens is the teacher has divided. We divided the teachers into groups, and they all have WhatsApp, so they all formed groups through WhatsApp. And if there is a activity or a something that they have to read, understand, get back, something that they have to draw. We give them sort of a 20-minute break. And this is called asynchronous time. Asynchronous is basically that they are not online. I mean, they could be online on their phones, but they're not online with the teacher at the same time. So the teacher sort of is silent and they're all working on their own. And then they come back and they show their work or we discuss their work that they have done.
This how we can do is we can give it homework instead of we waiting for 20 minutes. So when we engage with them for 60 minutes, we will be with them synchronous.
Okay, so that's what you prefer.
Because our volunteer time is precious. They would like to come and go. I think if we enable some more teachers, probably they can experiment both. Suma, okay. I see Suma madam here. Suma madam, any thoughts? Are you able to hear us? Can you unmute and speak?
Namaskara, sir.
Namaskara, madam. So,
Shinapi teacher.
Thank you. Wish you the same, madam.
Thank you, sir.
Neevu salpa comment maadi. Ivaru Kannada barutte. Deepthi also speak.
ನಮಸ್ತೆ ಮೇಡಮ್
ಹಲೋ ಹಲೋ ಸುಮಾ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ಹೆಂಗಿದ್ದೀರಾ
ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಮೇಡಮ್ ನೀವು ಹೇಗಿದ್ದೀರಾ
ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದ್ದೀನಿ ನಿಮ್ಗೇನು ಅನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ ಇವಾಗ
ಮೇಡಮ್ ಇದು ನನಗೆ ನಿರಂಜನ್ ಸರ್ ಮೊನ್ನೆ ಶೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಇದನ್ನ ಇದ್ರ ಲಿಂಕ್ ಈ ತರ ಇದೆ ನೋಡಿ ಮೇಡಮ್ ನೀವು ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಅಂತ
ಓಕೆ
ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಗೈಡ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ನಮಗೆ ಈ ಆಪ್ ಅಲ್ಲೇ ನೀವು ಹಾಕಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ನಾವು ಟೂಲ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಬುಕ್ಕು ಅದು ಇದು ಹುಡ್ಕೋ ಥರ ಇಲ್ಲ ಬಟ್ ಮಕ್ಳ ಎದುರುಗಡೆ ನಾವು ಇದ್ದಾಗ ಯಾವ ಥರ ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ನಾವು ಟೀಚ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಅವ್ರ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ನಾವು ಯಾವ ಥರ ತಗೋಬೋದು ಅನ್ನೋದು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಬೇಕಿತ್ತು ಮೇಡಮ್
ಓಕೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ನಡೀತಾ ಇರಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಓಕೆ
ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ದೀಪ್ತಿ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಡ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಸುಮಾ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ forced to do online classes. She has been doing only physical classes, right? She is also new to this platform. And now it's a different experience because now what happens is if they don't even switch on the camera, then what will you do?
करेक्ट बट आई मीन दिस इज सॉर्ट ऑफ अ चैलेंज फॉर एवरीबॉडी राइट आई मीन इट्स न्यू फॉर अस एज वेल सो आई थिंक सम वेज इन विच यू सॉर्ट ऑफ टू कीप चेक इज टू मे बी यू नो ऑन योर व्हाट्सएप इफ इट इज अ स्मॉलर सेट ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स टू मे बी कॉन्स्टेंटली चेक ऑन व्हाट्सएप इफ यू सी समबडी इज नॉट देयर और यू नो दीज आर सम वेज in which you can sort of bring them back to the conversation or the lesson.
No, actually, this I have figured out how to do it. At least in my Sundays, tomorrow I engage with them, about 100 kids come.
Okay.
If you start showing them the things which they like, then everybody, there will be competition to switch on their camera and come and talk to the person who is taking. I think that depends on how you are engaging. For example, this story which you mentioned, this is an excellent
Correct.
Way to engage. For example, you ask,
Correct.
There is question answer here in the story, then you can do live question answer.
Correct.
Yeah, child and, ask. Yeah, go ahead.
Sorry, sir. And also, see, one way to bring it to them is to always keep them on their toes. Like, you know, keep asking them questions. Like, is there a story that you have heard, you know, in your, you know, village, city, district, whatever? How do you know about it? Where did you read about it? You know, if there are stories that your grandparents have told, then, you know, how do you think they got to know? If, you know, there is some tale of the village or of the thing, then to ask them, you know, from where did they hear it? Do you think they would have been there? So I think to just constantly keep probing them will sort of keep them engaged.
Yeah, that is true. Suma madam, to answer your question, it comes by experience. Anyway, since it's your student, nimge gotirodrinda, you can call out their names once in a while, like how I did now, right? I took your name and now I'm going to take Shivaranjini's name. Okay. Shivaranjini, can you unmute? Shivaranjini, can you hear me? Okay. Or Megha, you can answer. Megha, does this interest you, the social science? I know you came in to teach the Scratch and other Python and others. Does this interest you, Megha? Megha, I'm not able to hear you. Yeah, let's continue. I think there's some challenge, I think, with her microphone.
Sure.
Yeah, go ahead. We will figure out how to get the attention of children. One is activities we can do.
Yeah.
I keep showing them the Scratch animation and we can get creative to create the Scratch animation even for history. Akbar, Birbal, Tenali Rama, all those things we can bring it, right?
Yeah. So, any sort of story can be made interesting, and you know, and you will find plenty of videos on YouTube. And as I go through this lesson, at the end of that lesson, there's a very interesting video. So if you even, you know, somewhere in between, it can be shown, and students can talk about it.
Yeah, can you show us the video?
Yeah.
Milind, good morning. Thanks for joining.
Good morning, Kiran.
Yeah, Deepthi, Milind has joined from Pune.
Hi, Deepthi. Hi, Milind.
Hi, Deepthi. How are you?
Good. How are you? Nice to have you here.
Yeah, thanks.
I'm just playing this. This is in Kannada, but it has subtitles, so you can read.
Yeah. Yeah, I think we can pass that. We got the idea.
Yeah.
So, yeah, this is an excellent way. I think this looks like it has been shot by Meghshala only, right? It looks so clear and it looks...
Yeah. No, I think we found this on the net.
Oh, wonderful. Yeah, it is. I think very relevant, in especially with the kind of audience in government schools whom we are targeting, they can relate to them.
Correct. And I think that is also the other point that I wanted to bring is that it has to be relevant to them. If most often we see that, we are showing videos which has these extraordinary using these extraordinary technologies or applications and instruments which are not available for these students. So it has to be something that they can find, or they can probably make, or something like that sort of helps them to connect and make it real. Otherwise, there is a chance that you can lose their interest, even if you show something that that they have no connection to.
That's I agree with you. Interestingly, Milind writes this kind of stories himself.
Oh wow, that's great, Milind.
What, Milind, can you share?
Yeah.
What did you write? One book you had given me to translate.
Yeah, actually, what I had done was some of the stories which are already there, right? I mean, some folk tales or Jataka tales and stuff like that, where there are some morals involved. So what we do is, I just have some dialogues which are written in a poetic form, so that the children can enact that drama. I mean, we normally do it during our Ganesh festival, where we have children enacting those dramas. So since the dialogues are all in poetic form, children, I mean, can memorize it very easily, and they have a lot of fun doing that. So
now, how do you intend to do it online, Milind?
Actually, what we have done this time, we had enacted a drama where I had just put in dialogues from various fairy tales, and I had made a mix of that. I can send you the details of that, where it is a mix of all the characters from the fairy tales, and the name I had given was Drive Me Crazy, right? So there, what we did this time was, since we could not have this Ganesh festival, the public gathering,
right?
Yeah, so what these kids did is they shot their individual characters at home. Individual, they are there. And then my daughter learned some, what is the name? OpenShot. Yeah, she just downloaded OpenShot and she learned it online, how to go about it. And then she edited those videos, mixed all the videos, and then we had a very good drama. So I can send you the link for that also. You can just watch it and see.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
Nice. So similar to the video that we just saw, it can even be done in a class. I mean, the teacher can just take pictures of some old things, then ask students, all this was found in a house? Where do you think, who do you think lived in the house? How many people do you think lived? What sort of occupation do you think these people were doing? And this is all just, and especially because this is the first time that they are studying history, it is so important to know, to learn about sources and, what sort of information we can get from them. And this sort of forms the base for everything that they will learn in history from now on. And that's why I feel like this is a really sort of important chapter for them to, for teachers to, it's important that teachers spend a lot of time in teaching this.
Yeah, folks, if any of you are interested in history, I was following Bill Gates and Khan Academy for some time, and they have invested millions of dollars in creating this history, world history, in a very palatable way. Okay, so if any of you are interested, I can share you the link. They have done it so well. It's so exciting, even for us individually, if not for teaching, to learn from what these biggies are doing. And back home, our Sudhamurti and Infosys Foundation, they have investing Yeah, they are investing quite a lot to revive our own Karnataka history from the script which they find in temples and old writings which are again thousands of years old. And our founder Chris Gopalakrishna is having another initiative called Itihasa, which is nothing but history only, right? So he's actually has an entire organization. Some of the ex-infoscians are driving this. Another very interesting project. So history is really very interesting when once we dig deep into it.
Yeah.
Actually, Kiran, the way we are taught, no, nowadays, we have to remember a lot of things, a lot of dates and all that. Instead of that, if they read it as a story, because these children, they read all the Harry Potter and other books, which are like 7 volumes, such big books. And my daughter can remember, every dialogue in that, actually.
Yeah, that is true.
And these stories are so complex, right? Like this Harry Potter, there are so many characters and it's so many, so complex. When something like that, the only reason they remember is it's, you know, told in a story form, it's interesting.
Yeah, and there is no test after that. There is no mandatory, you have to finish this book in this time and all that. So all that is not there. So they read it in a relaxed atmosphere and they remember everything.
Yeah, that's exactly true. Yeah, we have to empower them and we have to encourage them to come and narrate the story or enact the drama. Like Milind, how you did, that's a very interesting experiment which any of us can emulate. I know my daughter, she did that drama to actually, she's a badminton player. So her entire team, as if somebody is serving and somebody is receiving. So like that, with just in mobile phone, you can do all the stunts and you can narrate a story. I know this hippocampus, who are also part of our other teachers group, they are conducting competition through this. They are actually making them to do the dance drama through this. So this digital thing is opening up a lot of possibilities. We have to be creative. Now let's hear from Kausar. Kausar did a very interesting geography lesson on video in Urdu using Urdu fonts. Kausar, can you unmute and share your experience?
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, madam. Yeah, can you tell us what triggered you to do that geography with combining your voice and how you engage with the children with WhatsApp and just mobile?
Sir, I just made WhatsApp group. I just made WhatsApp group.
Heli, madam.
In sending videos to students, sir. That is in general topics like geography, regarding earth and atmosphere. I'm taking simple general things.
Yeah, interestingly, the one which Kausar shared with me, it had Google Maps. So it is a real to the scale representation of the world. And she is explaining various continents. And I was surprised. This was the first time I was able to follow a Urdu video, even though I don't know head or tail of Urdu. But I was able to follow what she is telling by relating to the map which she was showing and talking. And I knew I can figure out she is talking about continents. So like this, when you combine with your commentary as well as pictures, the history also can become very exciting. And Geeta, can you hear? Can you unmute and speak how you are showing giraffes and dinosaurs in your Kannada class there too?
Yes, sir. Happy Teachers Day, sir.
Thank you, madam.
And happy Teachers Day who all are in the group in this session.
Hello, madam.
At present now, for a few slides, we'll use PPTs and we are continue our classes with our live class sessions, sir.
Yeah. Don't worry about the technology. Impressed me was the way you stitch the story together, right?
Yes, sir.
Because
yes, sir.
It won't look like cut and paste. It is easy to get videos from YouTube and using your mobile, you can just stitch it together, but then it won't be a story. But what you have done with your commentary, nicely flowing through. So, can you share how do you basically how much time do you spend in choosing the videos? How do you stitch the story together? Same concepts can be easily applicable even for history as well.
Sir, actually, when I'm preparing some videos, actually before we started with the videos, before I start my first video, I had gone through with the all YouTube videos. By the time, I have got an idea what how can I prepare videos. Then basically, I prepared first one PPT slides. Then along with that, I started giving a voice through X recorder. After that, I felt it is not completely satisfied that then better I have to go through with the some pictures as well as some videos also and relevant thing if I get from Google and even YouTube all those things I can merge and do it. By the time I met you, I have attended your meeting, sir. In that I have seen and you were explaining about augmented reality. And why can't we adopt for that thing also in my video, I thought. And few slides I have done for videos for even my to create my class videos also. Along with that, I have given explanations. In this way, I created all those videos. Now, at present, we stopped doing that videos and we are started with our live classes, sir.
Live classes means what? You don't use videos anymore, is it?
Videos we are not creating about that particular lesson, sir. Related lesson, if we get any source like that, we'll use it only for just 1 or 2 minutes. We'll use it, sir.
Okay. And also, you were telling you share the videos one day before so that they can go through the video and come to the class.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That we will do it.
Yeah.
That some related messages or related pictures, related videos, and some clippings if you get about, for example, if you are going with a particular autobiography with the person, for example, DVG, what we'll do is some poem of his which they sang and which they have created videos like. ಕಿರುಚಿತ್ರ ಅಂತ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರಲ್ಲ ಅಂಥದ್ದೇನಾದರೂ ಇದ್ದರೆ ನಾವು ಅವರಿಗೆ ಕಳಿಸ್ತೀವಿ ಆಗ ಅವರು ಏನಾಗ್ತಾರೆ ಒಂದು ಸಲ ದೆಲ್ ಬಿ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಕ್ಯೂರಿಯಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಲರ್ನ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ದೆನ್ ಐಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮೈ ಲೈವ್ ಲೆಕ್ಚರ್ ವಿತ್ ಫ್ಯೂ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಬೈ ವಾಟ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಲರ್ನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಆರ್ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಪೋಮ್ ವಿಚ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೆಂಡ್ ಟು ದೆಮ್ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ಲಿ ದೆನ್ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ವಿಲ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ವೆಲ್ ಸರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ವೇ
Wonderful.
I think that's a really interesting way to do, especially for social science.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Geeta, do you also handle social science, or I thought you are only Kannada?
Sir, actually, I have done my B.Ed. in Kannada medium, social studies as well as Kannada.
Oh,
So,
wonderful.
working in international school, I can't handle social studies because I studied in Kannada medium. So they are not ready to give it to me. But still, if any particular subject in the history which comes in my subject, definitely I'll try to make them understand well. So after that, after I'm doing all this lesson, then students will say that, ma'am, how you know about all these things, ma'am? You are Kannada teacher, no? How you know about all this history? You'll explain nicely all these things they'll say. Yes, even though I am Kannada teacher, I know about history. So it's my passion of teaching. Even I like to teach history also, just I'll say, and I'll try to make them understand.
Yeah, very nice to
So
know.
the
Dipti, do you have any Kannada content in Meghashala? Kannada subject content?
Yeah, all of our lessons are translated into
No,
Kannada.
no, no, not Kannada medium. Yeah, I know Kannada medium,
No.
but Kannada as a subject, do you have?
No,
for
no, no. Kannada is a subject we don't have in Meghashala.
sixth and seventh also you don't have, is it?
No, no, no.
Why is that? Is it intentionally left out or?
It not. I mean, I don't think we sort of had in the team itself. There was there were people who had that sort of knowledge or command over the language. So
okay, that's okay. Yeah, anyway, I think with the skill which Geeta madam has, I'm sure she can create her own content and contribute to Megashala.
Thank you for sharing, ma'am. It was really nice to hear from you.
Thank you,
Deepthi, for your information, Geeta teaches in a place called Bailukuppe. It's about 160 kilometers from here. It's one of the Tibetan monasteries there.
Oh, okay,
yeah. There, she teaches in one of the private schools.
Oh, okay. Great.
So, yeah, good to see people across Karnataka joining us. Anybody else has any question, instead of just going one way, we will make it interactive.
Any sort of apprehensions or questions that you have regarding, like, you know, generally teaching, or even if it is regarding social science, I'll be happy to help you with.
You can ask about any other subject also. Having been with Megashala, I'm sure she will at least have some views.
Actually, Deepthi, one input. I don't know, you also might be doing it. What we do normally, when we are teaching history in our school, we first, instead of going through all that Indian history and world history and all that, we tell the kid to find his own history. I mean, his parents, his grandparents, great-grandparents, where they lived initially, why they shifted and all that. So when the kid is able to connect that history is not something which is about others only, it is about me also, then that connection with that subject is that much more, and then he can relate immediately to the other stories also.
Correct. I was actually just telling this group, I don't know if you had joined by then or it was before that, that, you know, connecting to their lives is the most important thing. I mean, if you, you know, get them to question why, from where, what, I think that sort of develops that aptitude towards the subject.
Yeah, and the lesson in history is always about their history. They put some pages together about what they did, where they came from, what language they speak, all that stuff. And then they are very interested in telling the other kids about their history. So automatically they know what is history about, all about.
Correct. Also, I mean, moving away a little bit from the topic, also, Kiran, this Google Earth, I think that is also an app, especially to show historical places. You can put a pin and you can, you know, it sort of zooms in, takes them through. If you can share screen and show for students, that's a very good tool. We have used those to make videos.
Yeah, I agree with you. Yeah, they have made it so interactive. And also you can get a street view and all, right, in that?
Exactly. Especially if you're doing like Vijayanagar Empire and all. If you, you know, go toward, if you sort of put Hampi as the location and say street view, it really takes you through all the sort of remains and ruins and everything.
Yeah. That is true. And even for the modern day things also, if you can go and see Louvre Museum, you can go and see White House. So all those things they have done, and also Taj Mahal, everything you can see as if you are standing in front. Yes, that's an excellent source.
And it's a great way to capture their attention also. Then they are looking at the screen and it makes it easier to take the conversation forward.
True. And I have seen the AR headset, which is the Google Glass, Google Cardboard, Google Cardboard.
Yes.
That's a very interesting way, where there are a lot of free apps. Google Cardboard costs as less as 500 rupees, which I'm sure the teachers can afford. But anyway, that happens only when you start engaging in person, once the vaccine comes. Right? Now it will be challenging.
Yeah.
Okay. Otherwise, it is such an interactive, I could stand in front of the Taj Mahal and walk into Taj Mahal with that.
Yeah.
With just 500 rupees standing sitting in my house. you can share this with your students so that they can experience in their home. Now, anyway, correct. Amazon will deliver wherever you want. Take one. Or you can create your own Google Cardboard. There are specs available. You can just download and create. All you need is two lens for your eyepiece.
Correct. Correct.
That's all. And you are anyway, your smartphone does the rest of the magic.
Correct. I think we should encourage them to create their own. It's a great learning, and also it's so easy to do it.
Yeah, that's true.
Any other questions?
Any other questions, folks? Milind, Geeta, Kausar?
No.
Megha?
Dipti, if you can share some of those videos you just mentioned, right? Where?
No, it's all part of this one, Megashala app.
All right. Okay.
Yeah. All of them are part of Megashala.
That is the advantage of platform, Milan. You need not have to carry, download, upload, no WhatsApp. Nothing. Everything is in one place.
Yeah.
So, yeah. And also, good part is I have requested for offline content so that we can distribute wherever the schools don't have internet, good internet connectivity. So that using web app or this Megashala mobile app, you can seamlessly access the content. That's what we have done with these students now. We have loaded 6th and 7th full 2 years Megashala content onto their phone and given it to them. So like this, we can scale up, we can resolve any challenges. Okay, so don't worry about content. Content we have, overload of content.
Yeah, and you will find a lot of other content to support as well. So I don't think content is the problem.
Right. But Dipti, do you think that just by going through the content like a video or something like that, there has to be a facilitator always, right?
Correct. There has to be a facilitator. And also, it is, showing a video does not amount to being an interactive session. There has to be discussions around it. There has to be it has to properly conclude. It has to begin in an engaging way, conclude in a, proper way. So only then does it become meaningful.
Right.
And you need to ask questions to help them, to get them think. Maybe give them few, also help them reflect, right? Like what is happening around them, or even, stories they have heard or whatever, to help them reflect on, what they think is right, wrong.
Correct. And you would, if some teachers from here, from Pune would be interested, like any topic or any history lesson or something like that, the way you do it in Megashala. Is it possible for us to do something like that? I will just check if people are interested.
Yeah, you share, Milind. Definitely, sure. We will make them available. Yeah, we have to just give them some advance notice and they will plan their other work and they will help us out.
Yeah.
Even if it is a half an hour or 1 hour, no? I mean, less than 1 hour, that is also okay. Just to get get feel of how it is done, so that people will pick up from there.
I mean, the easiest way is to just access our web app and go through our content. And, we can spend half an hour to an hour to just sort of help you understand what it is and the thinking behind that.
Correct.
Yeah, here.
When these things are going to be, all schools, because there are still some schools which go in the conventional way. when will it be that all schools will start doing it this way is really a question.
Yeah.
No.
That is what we are striving towards, right? Like, when do we? So that's why we mostly work with government, because that's the, sort of change that we are looking at.
Yeah, actually what happens, many of the government schools, because they themselves may not be having many teachers, and even if the teachers are there, they probably may not have access to all this material which you're talking about. I feel that many of these private schools suffer much more because they feel that they are doing the best and they stick to what they are doing actually, instead of opening up and really accepting the changes that are going around, right?
Right.
Yeah, Milinda, to give you comfort, okay, so now Meghshala is also available on Diksha app.
Okay.
Diksha is being now being rolled out across India by Ministry of HRD.
Diksha app, alright.
Diksha, D-I-K-S-H-A.
Okay.
And interestingly, you know who has built Diksha?
Nandan.
Nandan Nilakani. Yeah, it's X step basically. So, and look at, go to Meghshala, their website, and they will, you will also see how many schools they have already covered and what is their mission and how, what they are doing. So that gives us hope. And anyway, now we are joining hands with them, no? Now we will give them an army of volunteers who will take it to the schools.
Definitely.
And you are
the,
there.
The problem what I have faced, no, is some of these private schools that are, like I said, they are not really open. I mean, they feel that what they are doing is the best. So how to break in there is a question. I mean, how
No. Private schools is a different motivation is different there. There, unless you know the owner, you cannot do anything.
Correct.
Yeah.
Okay. So
and
yeah.
And also, it's very difficult to make these behavioral changes.
Correct.
If the school leader or the, you know, trustee or whoever is has not bought into this philosophy.
Right.
So let me just show. Hold on. Okay, any other questions, Geeta or Kausar?
Iran Manel Kutidia, Infosys Kutidia?
Nah, Manel Kutimpa. Just the virtual background I'm using. Yeah, let me just share my screen, hold on, so that I can show some of the Meghshala content, sorry, Meghshala website. Milinda, can you see my screen?
Yeah, I can.
Yeah, look at this, they are in three states and 2,500 schools, that's a good number, right?
Yeah.
So, yeah, now we can add a couple of hundred more. So, because there is a relevance, and most of the, it is being, the, quite a few of the Teach for India fellows have joined Meghshala. And yeah, they are really passionate and they are taking it forward. And the content, as you see, you can see a lot of thought has gone into the each and every word they have typed, each and every picture they have chosen, each and every video they have created.
Each lesson goes, you know, it almost takes a month to sort of design one chapter, end to end. So there are a lot of sort of reviews that happen. There are.
Yeah, that's true. And Jo herself was a teacher earlier and she's very passionate. And she has exposure to the teaching in multiple countries, US, South Africa, and then India. So all the experience, and she has excellent network as well. So the best minds are in action.
And Deepthi, just wanted to check with you. Actually, we do, I mean, I do a lot of things with maths, especially where actually I have taken up it as a task on myself that as many topics as possible, how to take maths through kinesthetic activities.
Right. Yeah.
Okay. So I don't know, I mean, whom I can contact, you or somebody, if I can just give you some inputs, because if there are some content creator people and all that, creation people. So something like a game is introduced, and then what I do normally, you know, when I'm teaching some of these kids, I mean, some conventional school kids also come. So twice in a week, I have these sessions with them. So I actually make get all the different items for with which they can play, and I just tell them from here that you put the bucket there, you throw the ball inside the bucket, and all that stuff. And they actually do it there, and from that a concept is automatically revealed, something like that.
Okay.
So these things through this content and this, if we can do something like that, right? Where you have a video and you give the instructions that do this, and then is this what you learned and all that stuff. So something like that, if that can be developed, if there are experts in, I mean, you would have experts to develop this that content, right?
Milind, we will work with you. Don't worry. We will will contribute it to Megashala.
All right. Okay.
Yeah, Megashala actually. Just to let you know how they are set up is they want to ensure that it is run almost at zero budget if possible, because by reducing the cost then only they can scale up. Otherwise, if it adds to the cost each of these content creation, then somebody has to fund them, right? They are because they don't give charge anything for the content, so there is no sustainable revenue source for them. So They run through support by various enterprises and the CSR activities
funding.
Of the various funding. Okay. So in that way, basically we have to give them both resources and volunteer power. Then they can share their experience and what works, and they can help us. We can distribute on their platform. We can have an excellent reach.
Yeah.
And they are across the states.
Yeah. So what I was thinking was, because some of those videos you told me yesterday, no, the three blue, one brown, those sites and all, the video content is so nice. I mean, if I were to probably sit and try to do it, I probably would take a lot of time, and then I should be having access to all those apps, and then I have to learn and all that stuff. So I thought that if somebody is already doing such stuff, given that, I mean, I could explain to them that this is what I intend to put in that video. So if something like that can be done, that's what was.
Yeah, give me the idea. No, now we have hundreds of teachers, students are working with us. No, tomorrow morning, 11 o'clock, they will come. I have already given them a very interesting project. Then this can be another project. No,
right.
In fact, we also have engineering students joining us tomorrow.
All right, great.
So don't worry about volunteers.
Right.
Yeah, any other questions? Otherwise, we are holding up Deepthi.
Deepthi, because I didn't, I was a little late. Just wanted to check with you, what are you doing with Megashala? I mean, what is your role and capacity?
I'm a curriculum designer and trainer. I design curriculum for the social science team.
Oh, right. Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
So all these videos and all, you get people to do it, is it? Or you also do it?
Some of the videos, quite a few, especially for lower grades, are made in-house. We look through stories and, you know, we sort of do a storyboard and then make these videos. Our design team does it. But a lot of it is also from YouTube. And since we can use only Creative Commons videos, it especially for history, it becomes very difficult to find videos that are, you know, that we can sort of put in our lesson.
Correct.
Yeah, Deepthi, Milind joined Infosys with me. He's
a
old timer, and then he took volunteer retirement. Then he is working with an NGO called Gram Mangal in Pune.
Where
they are teaching in a non-conventional way, like how our Rabindranath Tagore's institute is similar to that.
Like an alternative school.
Alternative school. Basically, they sit under the tree and they will learn.
Like
they
a Gurukul system.
Gurukul. And they also learn by doing. There is no typical smart class or anything.
Correct.
All by activities.
Deepthi, I mean, we call all these schools as alternate schools. My idea is that they should become the mainstream
school. The mainstream school.
Yeah, he also keeps creating content through PPT, his narration, and he writes books and yeah, whatever in his capacity he keeps doing.
Have you heard of Storyweaver?
Storyweaver, no.
It's by Pratham. I'm sure you would have heard of
Yeah,
Pratham.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
They have something called Storyweaver.org, which is it's a free resource. They have tons of stories, and they have stories related to even math, science.
Right.
We use a lot of them in our lesson. They are you just need to sign up, and you can download and read. They are leveled, so it's a nice repository of stories.
All right. Okay. I think I have seen some of those books. We were using them as part of our training in our school.
Correct.
Yeah.
Milind, we are connected with Pratham team as well. If you want, we can connect with them.
Yeah, definitely.
So I think if there are no more questions, I think we can close the session here. Thanks a lot, Deepthi. Thanks for joining
us.
No worries.
Now we
know.
I hope this was helpful.
Yeah, definitely. And good point is, quite a few of my friends also joined and they shared experience. Otherwise, I would not have known what Milind is doing in history. Right? Or what Kausar or Geeta are doing in their respective thing.
It's really nice to hear all the stories.
Yeah.
All the best, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot, folks, for joining. Let's catch up in the evening if any of you are free. Deepthi, every Saturday 7:30, we are having similar Microsoft Teams. Teachers come there, and they ask questions and we answer. They can ask any question.
Okay.
And so far, we are able to answer 100%. That's our track record. It's almost 2 months now, and we were very happy.
These are related to pedagogy or just general?
Anything they can ask.
Okay.
For example, Geeta mentioned about augmented reality. So one teacher came and showed me one Kerala teacher using augmented reality in her school. Then they asked how they can use. Then we showed how they can use. Now they are all experts in creating augmented reality in their videos.
Wow.
So they are using it in their daily lessons with their children. Now we would like to take it to the next level. Augmented reality is good to show elephant and aeroplane in the classroom, but now we are also showing them how to actually use it in real life, how to teach kids how to learn music through augmented reality, how to repair a machine through augmented reality. If any of them are interested, we can also help them to create how to create these videos. Instead of using some apps, they can do from scratch. Okay, because thanks to Infi, we are exposed to those technologies. We are using Unity 3D. So we know how these videos are created, so we can help them out.
Sure.
Yeah, Deepthi and Kausar, Kausar, you want to say something?
Sir, Megashala is a good resource, sir. I downloaded some lessons. Once we open, it shows the methods step by step, and TLMs content are ready-made now. So we can follow it easily. It is also thought-provoking.
Thanks, Kausar. Deepthi, just to tell you, Kausar works in a government school, which is, I think, about 30 kilometers away from Mysore.
Okay.
And interestingly, she also invited her niece, nephew, who is in Saudi Arabia, to join our classes on Sundays.
Okay.
So we have become international now with respect to the students as well. And a couple of students from Germany join our tomorrow's class. They teach Python, software coding.
Oh, okay. Software coding.
Sixth standard students teaching 10th standard and engineering students on software. That's very interesting, right? So, they are very smart kids and good to see them joining.
Good.
Okay, then thanks a lot and have a nice day.
Okay, thank you. You too. Thank you, everyone.
Thanks.
Yeah,
bye bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks, Kausar. Thanks. Bye bye.